Hey, I'm JR, training manager here at Crutchfield, and in this video, we're going to get into OLED and LED TVs, what's the difference, and how to choose the right one for you. First, let's get into the fundamental difference between the two types of TVs, and it all has to do with light. An LED TV is a liquid crystal display, or an LCD, that is backlit. There is a panel of light bulbs shining light through that liquid crystal display that creates the image. On an OLED TV, each individual pixel, and there's millions of them, is its own light source. They create their own light, so there's no back panel of light bulbs. And that gives us some differences to talk about. Let's start with LED TVs. They're not all created equal. Your entry level or least expensive options will have something called direct backlighting. So that is light bulbs behind the liquid crystal display, but not that many light bulbs. As you step up from that, you get to something called edge lit, which is where there's probably more light bulbs, but they're along the edge of the TV on the top or the bottom or the left or the right. And those light bulbs shine into the middle and are dispersed through the liquid crystal display. Your top of the line LED TVs have more light bulbs directly behind the liquid crystal display. The best ones have super tiny bulbs, maybe even hundreds of them, creating those light sources. And you'll hear that referred to as full array local dimming, or FALD, or F-A-L-D. And that's your best bet with an LED TV. Because there's so many bulbs, they can be turned on and off in various zones. So if you're watching a screen or a show where there's, let's say, a darkened sky with the moon, the zones of lights behind the moon can be on while these other ones are off or dimmer to give you better contrast ratio. Let's compare that with how an OLED TV works. Instead of a bunch of light bulbs, each pixel on the OLED creates its own light. So that's pixel level dimming, significantly more precise. Take that same image idea with the darkened sky and a bright moon. Only the pixels lighting up the moon will be turned on and everything else can be turned off. So you get a significantly better contrast ratio. The darkest darks are darker, the brightest brights are brighter. And as a result, all of the colors pop, you'll have better edge detail, and it will be a better, more movie-like experience. The difference in the backlighting also affects the physical size of the TV. You'll notice that OLED TVs can be thinner because they don't have that wall of lights behind the screen. So let's take what we now know about OLEDs and LEDs and how they work with light and think about the light in the room where you want to put your new TV. We need to consider how bright your room is. Does it have a lot of windows? Is there sunlight? Are there lights on your ceiling that need to be on when you're watching TV? If you have a brighter room, you're going to want a TV that can also give you a brighter, vivid image in a bright room. And that is LED TVs all the way, just because of how they work with those backlights. If your room is darker and it's more of a movie theater-like experience, or if you can just control the light and darken the room a little bit, you will have a more movie-like experience with an OLED TV thanks to the individual pixel-level dimming and the better contrast ratio. Another issue with your room to consider is how wide is your viewing area? Is your seating area pretty much directly on the screen, or is it wider than that? Multiple couches and chairs and things like that. Because there is a difference in the viewing angle performance of OLED and LED TVs. Because of the way those TVs work, OLEDs will give you a wider viewing angle. So people sitting off to the sides of your room will get a better image with better colors, even though they're off to the side. If you have an LED TV, the people sitting looking directly at the TV will get the best image. Those off to the side, colors may not be as vibrant, the screen may not be as beautiful. So wider viewing angle, go OLED. If you're looking straight at it, you'll be fine with an LED. Next, let's talk about durability. How many hours should you expect out of your new TV? And this used to be a big deal, something to really consider. These days, you should expect to get thousands, maybe 100,000 hours out of either type of TV, LED or OLED. One thing to think about is the issue of burn-in. Technically, it's possible on an OLED TV, but you're gonna have to work to burn an image into your screen. Most OLEDs will have some sort of pixel shifting technology. They'll refresh their own image. So they are trying hard to prevent burn-in, even if you're trying to burn it in. So it used to be really simple. Bright room, go LED. Dark room, go OLED. But here's the thing. They've been working on fixing their shortcomings in each style of TV for years now. And so our best LED TVs have better contrast ratio than they've ever had. Our best OLED TVs are brighter than they've ever been. So that gap in performance has gotten way more narrow. It's still true. If you want the most movie-like experience in a darkened room, you probably want OLED. And if you have a brighter room, you probably want LED, but it's not as big a deal as it used to be. If you need any more help picking out a TV, there's plenty of resources available on crutchfield.com. There's a TV buying guide. There's articles that discuss this very topic and more. If you need more help or if you want to talk to a live person, you can also get in touch with us here at Crutchfield. Go to crutchfield.com/contact where you can talk live with one of our advisors either over the phone or using chat on our website. We also do answer the questions you post in the comments here on YouTube videos, so go ahead and ask your questions there. We'll answer it accordingly. Also, as long as you're here, please like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications. Thank you for watching.